to improve different areas of your life, career, health, love, feng shui tips for the new year as Kababayan LA starts right now. To go before we bid adios to 2011 and hola 2012. 2011, a lot of people are saying it was a rough year because so many calamities, so many disasters, marami pong naapektuhan, lalo na po sa Pilipinas. We're going to be talking about that because our work is not done yet. So many people are still suffering and they still need our help. But before that, of course, kailangan din po nating pag-usapan yung pagpasok ng 2012. In fact, California as a state has passed some laws that will affect our life, our business, our family in the year 2012. Yan po ang pag-uusapan natin sa ating mga balita. Pinoy na Pinoy, weekend
balita. This segment is brought to you by Philippine Airlines, your only non-stop flight provider to the Philippines for the 2012 Fiestas.
Let us talk about some new laws sa California na kailangan e maapektuhan tayo. Let's first start with drivers and car dealers. What's up with that?
Oh no, kasi before may mga drivers na pagka yung may mga checkpoint, ano, yung DUI checkpoint, pagka yung mga driver nakita nila, although they are sober, no, hindi sila lasing or they're not drunk, pero wala silang lisensya, the cars are being impounded. Ngayon there is a new law that the cars will not be impounded. They will be allowed to drive home or whatever. They will be cited, of course, you know. However, the police will try their best effort to locate the regional owner of that vehicle sa, para sila ang ma-cite, you know. Like I said, ngayon, kahit na hindi sila lasing at wala silang lisensya, yung mga sasakyan na yung dinadrive nila, hindi na i-impound ng mga police.
All right, that I guess is good news. It gives us a little bit of leeway. But also this one, medyo bad news siya, Ronnie, because vehicle registration fees will rise from $31 to $43 a year effective July 1st, raising $360 million for the state to fund DMV operations. Pero sinasabi, local fees may increase total registration cost. Ronnie, pagtaas ng registration cost.
I know. Of course, alam natin, ano, isa yan sa mga, ang dahilan niyan is the state of California doesn't have enough revenues that it was expecting to raise this year, ano. So, of course, ang papatawa nila ngayon ng extra taxes or fees sa kanilang word, ano, eh yung mga vehicle owners, mga motorists, at tayong mga ordinaryong tao, like you mentioned, ano, one of them will be a registration cost of our vehicles will go up. $31 to $43, ano, so sinasabing mga $12. Of course, one particular vehicle, the registration cost of that is maybe higher than other vehicles, lalo na pagka mga, yung mga high-end cars.
Right. Okay, now let's talk about education. If this is minor, I would say minor, very little victory for immigrants. The California Dream Act now will allow students who have graduated from a California high school or attended at least 3 years, and they can prove that they are applying for legalized status to apply for grants and fee waivers at community colleges and universities.
Oo, no, maraming pwedeng makikinabang diyan, no, mga estudyante. Like for example, we were talking about the Librojo case last week lang, ano, no, yung mga ganito klaseng estudyante, now they will be allowed to attend schools, colleges and universities, and may even apply for grants. However, merong yatang, I don't know kung paano itong kaklaro itong batas ito, baka loophole, kasi it says here, as long as they can prove that they're applying
for legalized status. Exactly.
On the one hand, is paano sila mag-a-apply ng legalized status kung there are no current immigration laws. I believe napag-usapan nyo ng mga immigration lawyers sa Kababayan LA that it will be very, very difficult for them to
apply.
Do this, you know? However, as long as you apply, I guess, depende kung ma-reject ka man later on or what, as long as you can prove that you're applying for legalized status, then you can apply for grants to attend schools and universities.
Also, speaking of victory, this is also victory for LGBTQ community. Public school employees must report anti-gay bullying, and schools must establish procedures to handle gay bullying complaints. And also, schools are now mandated to include gay history in textbooks and social studies courses.
Yeah, starting July 1, ano? Of course, ano, MLK, ano? Alam naman natin marami itong mga issues na ito. Kasi nga, as far as the state of California is concerned, alam naman natin na nagkaroon ng gay marriage dito. They were being allowed to get married, ano? Same-sex couples, may mga kasi rights sila na perhaps are being trampled upon. So now they're being immersed into the society, lalo yung mga kabataan natin, that, hey, you have to understand there's this certain type of people that you need to accept within the society at magkaroon kayo ng yung tinatawag na maximum tolerance as far as how are you going to treat them, especially in schools and wherever in the public.
And finally, Ronnie, marami pang mga balita, no? But we only have a few minutes left on the show, so make it quick. Hindi na tayo pwedeng bumili ng Dimetapp or Robitussin or NyQuil nang walang prescription.
That's true, no? At hindi lang yan, no? Hindi na raw pwedeng magbenta, mag-distribute ng shark fin, no? Alam naman natin, very popular yung soup na yan. Isa rin yan sa mga bagong California laws that will take effect January 1.
Okay, 2012. And Ronnie, balita naman mula sa Pilipinas, patuloy pa rin ang paglaganap ng mga pagtaas ng bilang ng mga apektado, mga namatay sa Bagyong Sendong. And not only that, Ronnie, dahil may panibago na namang pagbaha, another area of the Philippines has been struck once again.
That's true, no? In fact, at tumaas na nga yata ang mga confirmed na death toll natin is 1,453 and it's still going up. In fact, yung may mga rivers daw, mga water channels and mga bodies of water, bodies are floating, ano, everywhere. So marami talaga na salanta dyan. Hopefully, our kababayans, actually, in fact, may mga concerts that are now going on even in California and Edips, America, no? To help our kababayans, especially the affected ones, at sana nga makatulong tayo, no?
Okay.
I believe we have some things that, you know, for those who don't want, who cannot donate cash, you know, water, soap, hygiene kits are very, very important. Cooking utensils, mga ready-to-wear clothes, ready-to-eat food. Yan ay pwede nilang tanggapin for those who really, you know, can donate food and kind dito po sa ating mga kababayan po na apektado sa Mindanao.
All right, the Philippine Consulate in Los Angeles has released an advisory. Yan po ang mga kailangan ng ating mga kababayan sa Pilipinas. And for those of you, in addition to that, Seafood City outlets are also accepting donations. If you are donating in cash, they are accepting donations sa kanilang mga check stands. Some of the beneficiary, ang mga dinodonate po natin sa Seafood City supermarkets, ay mapupunta sa mga efforts ng Gawad Kalinga sa pagtulong sa ating mga kababayan sa Pilipinas. Thank you so much, Ronnie, for sharing those news stories with us. At alam ko, let's discuss some other California state laws sa next week dito sa Kababayan LA.
Of course. Meanwhile, Happy New Year po sa inyo, no? Please be safe and, you know, let us all welcome the new year in a very good light.
All right. Thank you so much, Ronnie Ligo, Editor-in-Chief of Midweek and Weekend Balita. Meanwhile, mas marami pa pong balita sa www.balita.com. At kahit hindi masyadong maganda ang mga balita mula sa Pilipinas, masarap pa rin pong bumisita, lalo na the months of January and February. Napakarami pong fiesta. I personally would like to go to the Sinulog Festival in Cebu. If you're not convinced, watch this.
This segment is brought to you by Philippine Airlines, your only non-stop flight provider to the Philippines for the 2012 Fiestas.